brings a new hope, a new day.
Every choice we make is a time down our way.
Every wish finds a good motion, diving in with our hearts wide open.
Welcome, Chairman of Disney Parks, Experiences, and Products, Josh D'Amaro.
Oh, you guys sound good. You sound good. Good morning, everyone. I am so glad to be here. We're all back at the D23 Expo. You're all doing good? I got a chance to see a lot of you walking out on the floor and saying hello. I love spending time with you. What a way to start. How about another huge round of applause for Jordan Fisher? I am guessing that a lot of you recognize that music. You recognize that music? Yeah, that's the theme song from Happily Ever After at Walt Disney Resort. Yeah. If you're anything like me, you just flashed back to standing up on Main Street watching the sky light up over Cinderella Castle. Well, you know what? Let's get started with an announcement right off the bat, just for you, our biggest fans. I am so excited to share that next year we're going to bring back the Happily Ever After anthem as part of an updated Magic Kingdom. It's a nighttime spectacle. I know you guys love this stuff. I know it. I love it too. Now, as I listen to Happily Ever After, for the first time in a while, quite frankly, some of the lyrics, they hit me in a whole new way. Setting out for a new tomorrow. Every step we take brings a new hope. It brings a new day. There's no limit to where we're going. These lines mean a lot even more to me now than they did 3 years ago, which was the last time that we were all together here in D23. Of course, none of us could have predicted what lay ahead when we left this room back in 2019. But I gotta tell you, during those tough times, we all kept wishing together. We kept dreaming together. We kept finding Disney magic, and we did it all together. And through it all, you, all of you, you've been right there with us every single step of the way. You kept us going. You all kept me going. You all kept the Disney magic alive when we were all at home. And that was all of us, all the cast members around the world. They could feel your energy even though our parks were closed. And like the song says, every step forward we took, it really did bring us new hope. So now that we're finally back here together, I just want to say thank you. Thank you to all of you, our biggest fans. And I want you all to know this. I understand. I know how you feel about our parks. I know why you love being there with your friends and with your family. And I'm sure I've had a chance to meet many of you. I want to have a chance to meet all of you as I walk around our special places. I love those moments of connection because it lets me hear all of your voices. It lets me hear all of your stories. And most importantly, it lets me hear your dreams. I understand how much Disney means to you all. And I feel so lucky that it's my job to keep giving you brand new reasons to feel that way. I am so, so grateful that you're on this journey with us. Now, I know that change can be hard and we may not get things perfect all the time. But I also know that you want to be part of what we're doing and where we're headed. And that means everything to us. So then, where do we go next? Well, on Friday, Bob Chapek, he talked about the future of our company and how he wants to revolutionize entertainment yet again. And I can tell you, we see an absolutely boundless future in front of us where our theme parks, and even beyond our theme parks, they inspire the wildest imaginations and they exceed our greatest expectations. We're going to talk a lot about that future today, but I want to start with what makes the D23 Expo so, so special. This event, it gives us a chance to celebrate all things Disney, including, of course, our love for all of you, our fans. To our fans. One of the ways that we celebrate with you is through our park anniversaries, and 2022 has been a huge year for those celebrations. Right now, we're in the middle of the world's most magical celebration. All my Florida folks here honoring the 50th anniversary of the Walt Disney World Resort. Now, it sounds like you've all been there. We've unveiled new attractions. We've got new character moments. We've got new nighttime spectaculars. And there's so many other cool things going on there. And now, Epcot is only a short few weeks away from its 40th. Its 40th anniversary. And there is so much happening at the park as it continues its transformation. All right. How many of you have been on Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind? It's insane, right? I mean, that attraction is unbelievable. And I'm sure that you have a favorite song. Just a few of you. What's one of your favorite songs? Right here, September. You know what mine is? I was going to do just a little bit of a dance up here. My daughter somewhere in the background, she's like, please, Pop, do not do it. But I could kind of dance, but you're welcome, Kate. We all know that's a great track. Now, every time that I hear that track, I'm thinking about Cosmic Rewind. Let's go over to Disneyland Paris, where I hope you got to see Mickey light up the Eiffel Tower in honor of the resort's 30th anniversary. Such a cool moment for our cast and all our fans. We also have the new Disney D-Light drone show happening each evening over the castle. Really cool to see. And I am pleased to announce that the resort's 30th anniversary celebration, it'll continue through September 30th of next year. So if you have not got a chance to visit, get over there and check it out while there is still time. And as part of the grand finale for this 30th celebration, I am also excited to announce that we will have a brand new show coming to the Walt Disney Studio Park. It's called Pixar, We Belong Together, and it'll debut next year in the studio theater. This is going to be an amazing show. All right, let's stay in Paris just for a moment because There is a lot of momentum at Walt Disney Studios Park right now. I got the chance to be there just a few weeks ago for the grand opening of our newest Avengers Campus. It is amazing, it's spectacular. And you all know this, there is a lot more in the works over there. I'm gonna come back to that in just a little bit. Let's go over to Japan. Tokyo Disney Sea. Yeah, Tokyo Disney Sea just finished its fantastic Time to Shine 20th anniversary celebration. And then we're looking forward to Tokyo Disneyland's 40th anniversary next year. And then finally, as we wrap up this totally amazing year of milestones, we'll officially hit the 70th anniversary of Walt Disney Imagineering on December 16th. These are amazing people. Amazing people. Award-winning filmmaker Leslie Iwerks, she's hosting a panel discussion with our Imagineers later today celebrating this anniversary, and she has produced a fantastic video tribute, and that's going to be shown over there for the first time, so please get over there and check that one out. And now that brings us to Disney's 100th anniversary on October 16th, 2023. I mean, what an incredible milestone for our company. And as you've all been hearing all weekend, we are going to celebrate next year in a big, gigantic, huge way like nothing that we have ever done before. When I look back over our first 100 years, what jumps out at me is how we are just constantly reinventing ourselves, telling new stories for brand new generations. You all know this. We need those stories now more than ever. And that's a lesson we take straight from Walt. He believes in the power of storytelling. Our incredible cast members, the people who make that all happen, they carry on that legacy each and every day. Now, one of the coolest things in my role is I get letters all the time about how wonderful our cast members are. And I'm pretty sure that a lot of those letters are coming from the folks in this room. And I gotta say, I love hearing those stories. I read each and every one of them, so please keep them coming to me. I do wanna say thank you to our cast from around the world. These are the best people in the world. And they all, I wish I could have them all 170,000 of them right here today, but they are well represented here by our Disney ambassadors from nearly all of our destinations around the world. Let's have them stand. They're somewhere in here. There they are, right over here, somewhere. They're not quite lit up, but I know they're out there. They're somewhere. It's great to see all of you. Thank you for coming and representing our unbelievable cast members around the world. Okay, I have a lot of really cool news to share with you today. So I'm gonna go fast, so bear with me here. Are you guys ready to come along on a little journey with me? All right, well, let's jump into this boundless future because there is no limit to where we're going. Where are we? We are literally down the street from... Yeah, we are down the street from the Disneyland Resort. We got a lot of Disneylanders here, I know that. So let's start right there. You know, I got my start at Disney, at the Disneyland Resort. And no matter how far I am from Disneyland, it always feels like home when I come back here. It just marked its 67th anniversary, and I loved watching this special place transform over my time with Disney, bringing all of your favorite stories to life. One of the biggest additions has been Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. I got a chance to help open that in 2019. And since then, Star Wars storytelling has just exploded, and we're seeing all kinds of new characters and tales from that galaxy far, far away. And one of the folks responsible for some of those new stories is Disney legend, Jon Favreau. Which, of course, is why I'm so excited to have Jon join us today.
you.
John, maybe you just do the rest of the presentation. First of all, thank you for being here with us today.
It's always fun. I think last time was when we opened Avengers Campus,
it
right?
It was.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I got to hang out on stage there and see that all come to life.
Yeah.
You're a huge Disney Parks fan.
Yes.
I know that. You're obviously a huge Star Wars fan.
Uh-huh.
You talked about some cool stuff yesterday, I think, or the day before.
Sure.
How does it feel standing up in front of all these
people? It's great. It's great coming back here because it's been so long since we've been able to all get together like this. And the energy is great. Look, it's great to see people posting videos and communicating online. And there's a big conversation that goes on in the digital world. But to all get together in person like this it's really wonderful. And I'll tell you, not just for myself, but everybody else associated with it. The energy that you all give back, it makes it, that's why we love doing it. And the energy is fantastic. And, you're all cheering there and it's fun, but I can't tell you, it affects everything that people like Josh do, people like we do, because we know how much it's appreciated and how much fun everybody's having together. So I just want to reiterate the appreciation that we have to all of you for letting us do what we love to do.
Well, I can, to that end, John, I can remember standing in 2019 at Disneyland in front of Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, and there was a group of people, I'm sure some of you were there, who came in, and there were tears coming down people's face as they saw some of that stuff for the first time.
Because a lot of the people we work on the show with, like Doug Chang and a lot of the people from Lucasfilm and ILM, they were all, it's a big group of creatives. You think about Imagineering, they're such a company with so many different departments, but everybody comes together to work on things like this. I have the passion to get it right. We love the source material as well. And when you first walk into Batu, it's super cool. And I remember seeing the Millennium Falcon. I was there when they opened that park as well. So it's just been, just as a fan of Disney and of Star Wars. And George Lucas, like Walt, really understood how to mix storytelling with technology.
Yeah.
And how to create the magic using the latest and greatest that's available. And Walt, we think of it as kind of old-fashioned, but if you think of audio animatronics and monorails and all the technologies that he was pushing forward, it was, in the 50s and 60s, it was crazy. And it's nice to see that we're continuing to keep that legacy alive with all these innovations that you're announcing.
Yep. And they're going to keep coming.
Yeah.
Now, you, as part of your job, when you're standing up here on stage, you get to do all these kind of sneak peeks and things like that. I get to do them sometimes, but not like you guys. You want to do something like that today?
Well, I figure this is the perfect place to introduce people to something new, right?
They all came out.
Yep, let's bring somebody out.
I'm looking for someone. Was told to meet at Oga's Cantina.
All right. Hey, it looks like you got a little friend there.
All right, kid. Let's go find this trend. And a snack.
Safe journeys, Mando. It's good to see you.
This is the way.
Getting it started off strong. There it is. That's your first look at Mando and Grogu live and in person. Yeah.
Pretty cool. We've been working on this thing, I can't tell you, for years. And to the credit of Josh and the team and the Imagineers, they came down to the studio. They worked with Legacy and with the costume designers, went back and forth. Yeah. And I'm telling you, for those of you who like to cosplay or those of you who are big fans, every detail on that, we really meticulously went after. And then that we were doing this since before the lockdown.
Yep.
So this was something that's been a real labor of love. And I want to express my appreciation to you for keeping with
doing a great job.
We're so happy about this.
We have more good news. You're all the first to hear this today. We're going to be able to cross paths with these two guys at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge inside Disneyland starting in mid-November. So just a few weeks away. John, Hey, thanks for being here today. Thanks for everything you're doing.
So much fun. Thank
you.
All of you. Thank you.
Jon Favreau. He is amazing, and he's such a good partner, and he's so passionate about these parks. So to see that come to life, just really special. I'm glad that we could do that in front of you today. You know, our characters and their stories are part of what makes our parks and experiences so special and so different. And I can tell you what, we are not going to slow down here at all. Since we opened Avengers Campus at Disney California Adventure, we've seen how powerful these characters can be, with more than 50 of them appearing globally. Here in California, we introduced Iron Man, Black Widow, Thor, Black Panther, Captain America, Scarlet Witch, Loki, Shang-Chi, Loki, Mighty Thor, and of course, Loki. We've got Spider-Man swinging overhead. We've got the Dora Milaje showing us the way of the Wakandan warriors. And we've got Doctor Strange teaching us about the mystic arts. And you know what? Like I said, we are just getting started here. But what does just getting started mean? Well, to help answer that, I've invited another special guest. Everyone, please welcome the president of Marvel Studios, Kevin Feige.
23 Expo, hello again, Josh. Hey there. Hey, everybody.
It's Kevin Feige, everybody.
Good seeing you again.
It's Kevin Feige. I was backstage with Jordan Fisher a second ago, and he bumped into, actually, he hadn't met you before. I said, this is Kevin Feige. Jordan was having a tough time breathing up here after he got up to sing. All right, first things first. Did anybody see Kevin and his team up on stage yesterday?
Oh, great.
I've got an issue.
Uh-oh.
So Kevin gets out there, and he says, well, I don't get to do Broadway-style things. And he comes out, and there's people dancing on the stage, and I'm like, what the heck is, that's my territory.
That is the Disney inspiration that you bring to all of us.
Yeah, well,
to all of us.
Okay, thank you. I'm going to start making Marvel movies, though. You know, the Imagineers want to make Marvel movies.
I wish you the best of luck.
Well, listen, my team loves working with you and all the amazing things that you keep bringing out. And I know you're a big fan of Disneyland and you've got Avengers Campus.
All of the parks have, and it is still, I pinch myself. Not just that I get to make movies, but that I get to interact with the Imagineers, with Josh, on bringing these to life. Disney is, we've been a part of Disney now for over 10 years, and it was always the promise, gosh, maybe someday we could have something in the parks. And now that day has been here for a while, and I thank you for it. And I thank all of you fans for coming and embracing Avengers Campus and everything that's coming to the parks from Marvel, finally.
Well, we got Avengers Campus here.
Hey, guys. That's right here. I just wanted to jump in quickly. I'm watching a live stream, and this is amazing. But I had one suggestion just off to the side. You know, Avengers Campus is incredible, and I'm just asking you, maybe suggesting that you expand the palette a little bit. You got red and blue. You got red and gold. You got black and silver. I'm just saying you might need a little color. How about a little green to add to the mix? Just a suggestion. Asking you to think about it. I'll let you go now. I think you guys are doing an amazing job. Sending my love to everybody. I'm just going to step back and finish watching the live stream and hope there's some good news.
I think,
how do you get that number, first of all? You shouldn't be able to break
into it. I don't know who gave it to him.
But I think you should get your people on that. We could start working on that and get that in the works. I think that'd be pretty cool. You guys want to see a Hulk at some point?
Yeah, we could. Right now. Hulk, how you doing?
That was fast.
Yeah, we do.
Isn't this
fast.
Avengers Campus?
Yeah.
I'm supposed to meet Steve and Nat at Avengers HQ. I don't know what happened. What is this? One of those something cons?
Something. This is D23 Expo, Hulk.
Oh, the time-space GPS must be off. Now I'm annoyed.
Well, Hulk, we would love to have you at Avengers Campus. Maybe you can do like a meet and greet. You can see some of your fans. You could do like a visiting professor kind of thing, something like that.
I like it. I could make that work. Avengers Campus, get ready.
Hulk, great to see you. Hey, can you find the exit? Can you find
the
exit?
If not, I'll make one.
That's impressive.
It just keeps coming at Avengers Campus. Pretty cool.
He's big.
He's huge. Yeah. Up close and personal. Listen, if you want to meet Hulk, I've got some great news. He'll be appearing in Avengers Campus in California next week.
Nice.
Now, Hulk's got a lot of places to go, and you can only stay for a little while right now. Please do not miss him, but he will be at Avengers Campus next week.
Listen, I love that these guys at Imagineering and at the parks, it's amazing. You watch an episode, and the next day, there's a character in the park. You meet a character here on stage, the next week, they're in the park.
Yep.
It's really incredible, the amount of characters that your team has brought to life in Avengers Campus, and I thank you. It's amazing.
You keep making those great movies, we're going to do it. Kevin, I'm just going to ask you one thing, please. Just ask Hulk, don't have him smash stuff up, because, you know, the place is still new, and, you know, Spidey, you know... You know, he's done some damage over there.
I understood that reference.
Listen, this year has always been our vision for Avengers Campus, to give our guests more of what they love and then some. We want more stories, we want more heroes, we want more villains, and we want more of the land. We want more of the land to play in, too. And you know, Kevin, you spun fans into a frenzy this summer when you announced the multiverse saga of films coming our way. And I know everybody went crazy. And then you gave us even more amazing intel yesterday when you were up on the stage here. And that's why I'm thinking that maybe we should give our D23 fans here a preview of our plans for the parks.
Well, sure, we're bringing the multiverse to the movies, as you know. We're bringing the multiverse to our series on Disney Plus, and now we're bringing the multiverse to Avengers Campus.
Yeah, that's right. And as you heard, as Bob shared on Friday, we are expanding Avengers Campus here in California. And our creative teams have been talking about a third attraction from the beginning here. But when you filled us in on the multiverse, that sent us back to the drawing board for what this could mean to our land. And now, working with your team, Imagineers have come up with a concept that is entirely new. So, Kevin, we've got all of our biggest fans here in the room with us today. What can you tell us about the story and this new experience?
Well, you know, the fun thing about Marvel is the characters, all the characters, all of the time. And with the multiverse at Avengers Campus, you're going to be able to do that. And in this new attraction, you're going to be able to battle alongside all the Avengers against all the foes from anywhere, from every win that you can possibly imagine. And you're going to meet a new villain named King Thanos. This is a new version of Thanos for the very first time coming into the MCU via this attraction. And he's got a cool white beard, too. And a crown. This is a Thanos that won. And the Avengers are not too happy about that. And you have to help them.
So, Kevin, you all need to know, when we're building these new attractions, he is in this every step of the way, making sure the story comes through and it's exciting for all of you. This is incredibly exciting. He is incredibly exciting, and this is coming soon. And in honor of this special announcement, we've turned the awesome artwork that you're seeing right here into a print just for everybody in this room today. You're the only ones to get it, and you'll have it for you on your way out.
This print was made by the amazing Ryan Meinerding, and you should all know who he is. He's been the head of our visual development at the studio. He's designed almost everything you've seen and loved in the movies, and these are just some of the characters, some of whom you met before, some of whom you can look in there and you haven't even met just yet. It'll be them and more in this amazing attraction.
Well, you've given us a lot to look forward to here. We can't wait to venture further into the multiverse with you. Kevin, you're amazing. I appreciate you, and I thank you for being here today.
Thank you, Josh.
No more Broadway shows,
though. Thank you.
Though.
We'll see.
Stop that.
We'll see. Thank you, everybody.
Kevin Feige,
thank you very
everyone.
Much. Thank you.
So as you can see, we continue to have big plans for Avengers Campus here in California. And that's all I can say for now, but I promise you we're going to keep you updated on our progress here in this amazing, growing land. All right, I've got something else new for you in Disney California Adventure. Just around the corner from Avengers Campus, I am excited to share that we're about to reimagine Pacific Wharf into San Francisco Big Hero 6. This, everyone, is where East meets West and technology meets tradition. We're still in the early phases here of this work, but you can see glimpses of what's to come. There's going to be a place to meet Baymax, of course. All kinds of spots to eat and do shopping and all that. It's going to be a great experience as we continue to tell new stories in Disney California Adventure. Over across the street, we're also making great progress on the reimagining of Disney's Paradise Pier Hotel. And I am excited to share for the first time that its new name will be Pixar Place Hotel. This hotel, it's going to be super, super fun. You'll feel like you walk right into a Pixar art gallery. You'll see new interpretations of favorite characters like Woody, Buzz will be there, Mike, 22, Miguel, Dante, and all the Disney Pixar characters that you can think of. Of course, Pixar's artistry will be at the core of this totally refreshed experience. It's going to include fantastic communal areas like this Finding Nemo themed splash pad. The hotel is going to feel completely new. Now, I'm going to take you over to downtown Disney, where we have some big plans to introduce more than a dozen new and reimagined locations. You can expect a bunch of new options for shopping and dining that will showcase Southern California culture. Now, we've already shared that Michelin star chef Carlos Gaitan is bringing his vision for Mexican cuisine to Centrico and Paseo. And we're also excited that Din Tai Fung will join the district with its flavorful Chinese cuisine. You're seeing for the first time a piece of concept art that I think is coming along really well and looks cool. We have several other announcements planned for the next year and into the future, but I want you to be the first to hear this one. We're bringing a Southern California favorite to downtown Disney. It's a place that I love, and I hope you love. It's Porto's. Oh, we got some Porto's fans in here. Now, for those of you that have, in fact, experienced Porto's, you know this. This bakery is famous for its sweet pastries and its treats and its savory Cuban food and all the incredible desserts that they have. And trust me, it is all delicious. Now, some of you, I imagine, some of you out there in the audience might be wondering, well, what is this all about? Let me just say this. It's really good. And when you try it, you are going to love it. And you know what? You're not going to have to wait long because we are giving you all a special treat from Porto's today on your way out. But don't run out and get it right now, okay? We've got a lot more to share before you get those pastries. And speaking of running, that reminds me, the last time that we had a Run Disney race through the Disneyland Resort, when was it? Does anybody remember when the last one was? 2017. Well, the races are coming back. The races are coming back in 2024. We're gonna have a lot more details on that, the registration, all the fun stuff that comes along with that. But listen, I can't wait to see everybody out there again. I can guarantee you I will be out there running with you all. So as you can tell, we've got a lot of excitement happening across the whole Disneyland Resort. And let's please not forget, it all started with a mouse. We are going to celebrate Mickey and Minnie and their best pals in a whole new way at Mickey's Toontown at Disneyland Park. The highlight, of course, will be Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. I'm guessing some of you have experienced before. It's already a huge hit at Disney's Hollywood Studios in Florida. And of course, we're gonna make some very special adjustments to ensure that this version, it fits perfectly into our Toontown story. Today, you're getting a closer look at the attraction with these brand new renderings from inside the El Capitan Theater. And no matter when you met Mickey for the first time, there's gonna be something in there for each of you, from Steamboat Willie, to Mickey Mouse Club, to his desk at Mickey's Christmas Carol, all the way up to the present day. It is going to be a celebration of all things Mickey, which I love. I think some of you might know, I'm a huge, huge Mickey fan. Now, this reimagining of Disney's Toontown, it's gonna be fantastic. We are really stepping into a new era of inclusive experiences in this land of families for all ages. Now, I know from some of you out there that there was some concern that poor Donald is gonna lose his favorite boat. Rest assured, everyone, it's still there. Here's a first look at a new rendering that we have where you can see he's crashed it into Goofy's pond. And here, in this new rendering, you can see one of the silliest areas of new Goofy's How to Play Yard. It's a fun, interactive sound garden where little ones will discover new ways to make all kinds of noises. These new experiences will join existing favorites in Mickey's Toontown when the land reopens in early 2023. I can tell you, I've had a chance to walk around there a lot. This place is going to be great. So, let's go from Toontown and we're gonna head over to New Orleans. You all know this. I have loved talking about Tiana's Bayou Adventure. This is our reimagined attraction to set up to open at Disneyland and Walt Disney World in late 2024. And I'm thrilled that we're bringing a new Tiana story to our life, to life in our parks. And to tell you a little bit more about that, I want to hear from some of the Imagineers who are leading this project. So everyone, please welcome Carmen Smith, welcome Sherita Carter and Ted Robledo. Well, I guess Ted dances. That's right. You should have been out here a little bit earlier. I didn't have such luck with that. Well, listen, thank you for joining us here today. Ted, I'm going to start with you. We know that our story picks up right where the Princess and the Frog left off. So bring us into the story. What's happening here?
Thanks, Josh. So as we all know, at the end of the film, Princess Tiana realizes her lifelong dream when she opens Tiana's Palace. I mean, she's such an inspirational character, and in our brand new story, she's become this great entrepreneur and community leader. So, the year is 1927, and to celebrate carnival season, she's hosting a party for the people of New Orleans. But she discovers her celebration is missing a very special ingredient. So, and she needs our help to go find it. So we're gonna join Tiana and Louis. We all love Louis, right? We're all gonna take a magical trip to the bayou where we're going to meet brand new friends to invite to the party, and they have a very special role in these festivities. So I hope you're ready.
The story sounds amazing. I know how much passion you guys are pouring into it. And I'm excited about how the team is bringing this experience to life in some new and special ways. So Sherita, tell us a little bit about how this attraction is all coming together.
Okay, well, first of all, Josh, I just have to let you know, we have the most amazing team working on this attraction.
You absolutely do.
Yes.
Imagine you guys are just amazing.
And we are having with mock-ups, making this a transformational experience. When we are in these environments, it's important that they inspire a sense of awe in us. So we are taking advantage of that massive structure by using the latest cutting-edge technology to further enhance that sense of grandeur. And as you can see here, this attraction is going to be gorgeous at night. What I have always loved is when we have the opportunity to take our tried and true techniques and then combine them with our digital tools for animating and lighting to just create a brand new attraction experience for our guests. For example, we're going to use mist like a painter's canvas to create this amazing sense of aura, which is going to be different from anything that you have seen in an attraction. It's something that I like to refer to as true Bayou magic. And Josh, that's just the tip of the iceberg.
I know. Well, I love this idea of true Bayou magic. Carmen, can you tell us a little bit about the research that the team has been conducting in New Orleans to make this a really, really authentic experience?
Absolutely, Josh. I mean, that's what we're all about. You know, even though Tiana is a character in the story, her culture and the place she comes from is very real. We want this attraction to be a love letter to New Orleans. Yes. It's important for our guests to feel how we approach the story in an authentic way. You know, if you're from New Orleans, you should feel like you're coming home. You know, if you've never been to New Orleans, well, this attraction will make you want to go.
Well, I love this idea of a love letter. It's a great way to put it. I know that you and the team have taken multiple research to engage with the New Orleans community. Why don't you tell us a little bit about what that was like, the people that you met?
Okay. Well, you know, what makes the city so special is the people. And we've met some incredible individuals and groups. Their perspective have become a filter we're using for all aspects of our work. You know, in search of inspiration, we've been working with local artist Sharika Mahdi. Yeah, this is amazing work. You know, she created this and several other pieces to help us along our journey in developing this important new attraction. We've also spent time with Stella Chase Reese. She's really now an honorary Imagineer, an amazing woman. She is the daughter of Chef Leah Chase, who is the inspiration, you know, for Princess Tiana. You know, yes, indeed. We've been learning more about this important role that food plays in New Orleans culture. And here's one of my favorite quotes from the film. The thing about good food is it brings folks together from all aspects of life.
Absolutely, Carmen. I mean, that is so true, and it's said so well. I know we'll see food come to life in new ways at Disneyland too, and you're all gonna hear more about that in the near future. I'm so excited about all of these plans. So Carmen, Sharita, Ted, thank you so much for sharing with us today. Thank you for the fantastic work that you're all doing in bringing Tiana's first attraction to life. Really inspiring stuff. Now, I know our Disneyland and Disney World guests are gonna love this place when it opens in 2024. Thank you all, I appreciate
you. Thank you,
John. You guys take care.
Thank you.
Our brilliant Imagineers. We want Tiana's Bayou Adventure to feel like you've stepped right into her story, which is why I'm thrilled to announce that several of the film's cast will lend their voices to this attraction. We'll have Bruno Campos as Prince Naveen, Michael Leon Woolley as Louis, Jennifer Lewis as Mama Odie, and of course, Anika Noni Rose as Tiana. Music
is going to be a huge part of the experience as well. New Orleans has music embedded in its DNA. You don't just hear that music, you can feel it. So we're bringing that same vibe to this attraction. And today, we've got some musical inspiration that represents the heart and the soul of New Orleans. So please, get those handkerchiefs out. You got them when you walked in. And I want you to join me in welcoming Disney legend Anika Noni.
Told me fairy tales can come true.
Thank you, Anika. My gosh, and that band coming through the aisles. You guys like that? Woo! That was phenomenal. How about another huge round of applause for them with a little bit of handkerchief? So many things happening at the Disneyland Resort, and I'm not even done talking about it. But I'm gonna come back to Disneyland in just a little bit. For now, let's turn our attention to another place that I've had a chance to call home, Walt Disney World. Now, when I served as president of the resort, I got a chance to work with the team that was planning the 50th celebration, and I am just so proud of all the new magic and the new memories that they're creating for our guests. We've debuted two new nighttime spectaculars. We have Disney Enchantment at Magic Kingdom. Yeah, and we have Harmonious at Epcot. Well, both of them have been tremendous additions. And if you haven't seen them already, you definitely don't want to miss them. You definitely don't want to miss them. Because as I've been saying, we're always looking to the future. So I am excited to share that we're crafting an all-new nighttime spectacular for Epcot during the 100th anniversary celebration. Brand new show, and this show is in development right now, and it will debut later next year, continuing that park's legacy of inspiring nighttime entertainment on our World Showcase Lagoon. This is an exciting time for Epcot because we're getting close to another major milestone in its transformation. Our new neighborhood World Celebration is taking shape in the middle of our park. The neighborhood will feature CommuniCore Hall and CommuniCore Plaza, two great new locations for our festivals. And I'm also excited about Journey of Water inspired by Moana. That's coming to World Nature Neighborhood. It's the story of water on our planet. It's obviously inspired by Moana's friendship with the ocean. And as you make your way around the trail, you'll interact with the water and discover that it kind of has a mind of its own. Now, you are all the first to hear today that Journey of Water and the rest of the center of that park will be ready to welcome guests in late 2023. Before we leave Epcot, I've got just one more little surprise for you. There is a character that you can only find at this park. And I got a feeling he's probably a favorite of some of the folks in this room today. Well, for most of our lives, he's appeared only in our imaginations. But for a short period of time, years ago, you could actually meet this lovable purple dragon. Well, I am thrilled to announce that by the end of next year, you'll get the chance to meet Figment in person once again out in the park. Figment is back. I am going to have a lot more to share in the future, but our teams are right now hard at work bringing Figment to life, and I know that you're going to all be excited to meet him. And since we're talking favorite characters, let's head over to Magic Kingdom to talk about another favorite character. Ever since a certain Happy Haunt returned to Disneyland, our fans have been asking for him in Florida, too. Well, foolish mortals, we have heard you. And I am... I am fiendishly thrilled to announce that next year the Hatbox Ghost will materialize in the Haunted Mansion at Walt Disney World. Now, on Friday, we announced a new game that I'm really excited about. It's called Tron Identity. And it's a new take on the Tron universe that I think any of you gamers out there are really gonna love. Now, obviously, you'll be able to experience this game from anywhere. But if you want to physically enter the grid in a thrilling new way, well, I've got the thing for all of you. At Magic Kingdom, we're busy testing Tron Light Cycle Run. This will be a huge addition to Tomorrowland. And listen, I know that we've been talking, and then we were talking about this attraction for a while now. but I'm telling you, it's really close to being ready for showtime. So close, in fact, I got a chance to take an early test ride, and I figured I'd give you a sneak peek. Take a look. Listen, I fully realize that I have a really cool job, but I think you can tell how much I enjoyed that. And what you all saw there, that is just a little taste. It was great riding with some of the team members who have been so committed to this attraction through all of its unforeseen twists and turns. They're working on a lot of finishing touches right now, and we're excited for you all to experience it. That is why I am thrilled to announce to you today that Tron Light Cycle Run will debut in the spring of 2023. Okay, here we go. We're gonna leave dry land, and we are gonna head out to the high seas to talk about our award-winning Disney Cruise Line. Our majestic new ship, the Disney Wish, took her maiden voyage in July. Oh, she's beautiful and is already a huge hit with our guests. And now we're gonna build on that momentum, turning our attention to the next entry into our fleet. For our sixth ship, we're dreaming up a brand new design concept that feels unlike anything Disney Cruise Line has ever done before. The theme of the ship is adventure. Celebrating, you knew it. Celebrating Walt's lifelong love for exploration, this is gonna be an epic journey into Disney stories. And today, you're the first to see what the inside of this amazing new ship will look like. Here we go. It's looking good, huh? That grand hall is inspired by the grandeur and mystery of a gilded palace. It draws on real-world influences from Asia and from Africa, as well as the far-off land of Agrabah. As you see there, for the first time aboard one of our ships, the signature grand hall statue will feature three of our favorite characters, Jasmine, Aladdin, and their lovable magic carpet soaring together towards a whole new world of adventure. But wait here, there's a little detail. Do you all want to know the name of the ship? Yeah! Let's take a look. At the heart of every adventure, there is a treasure. And we can't wait for you to create memories aboard this spectacular new ship. Our growing fleet also allows us to go places that we've never been before. Because for our next adventure, I'm pleased to announce today that we will take the Disney Wonder to Australia and New Zealand. We will offer our first sailings in this part of the world beginning in late October of next year. The ship here is the destination on these voyages, inviting guests from this region into stories from Disney, Pixar, from Marvel, and Star Wars. And we're so glad to bring something new to those that may never have experienced this type of Disney magic before. Now, obviously then, I'm also excited to share that the Disney Wonders repositioning cruises will be our first South Pacific voyages, giving you the chance to experience destinations like Fiji and Samoa, pretty cool. And there's more. And there is more. Our Disney Cruise Line has started work on our new island destination in the Bahamas. I told you I had a cool job. I had a chance to visit recently, and I wanted you all to be the first to see it. Welcome to Lighthouse Point on the beautiful island of Eleuthera. We're still in the early stages, but I can tell this is going to be a spectacular location for our Disney Cruise Line guests. We have a long way to go, but just imagine the possibilities. That, it's gonna keep going. That was the first time that I was on the island, and I can tell you now from a personal point of view that Lighthouse Point is going to be absolutely stunning. It's inspired by the stories of the Bahamas, and we are committed to preserving and protecting the natural environment throughout this project. Get this, everybody, 90% of the power used at Lighthouse Point will come from solar energy, 90% of the power. And we're working with local advisors and artists to create a destination that represents the natural beauty and the rich culture of the Bahamas. We want this to be an authentic experience filled with all kinds of Disney magic. Here is a brand new concept rendering that I'm sharing with you all for the first time today. This is a great overview of what your day on Lighthouse Point will feel like. In addition, obviously to that gorgeous beach that you just saw a moment ago, you'll have a recreation center, you're gonna have food and merchandise locations, a youth activity area, and so much more. Here's another rendering showing a closer look at one of the island's pavilions. Here, you know, guests will be able to immerse themselves much more deeply into the Bahamian culture. We're excited to create a place where you can learn about the stories and the traditions that are passed down by generations of Eleuthera's residents. We know how much our guests love Castaway Key, so we can't wait for you also to put your toes in the sand on this new island destination. So more to come there. All right, now that we're back on land, let's see if we can, let's see how we're finding ways to make some dream locations come to life in our parks, and we're gonna start in Asia. If you've ever wanted to visit Zootopia, I definitely do. I hope you guys do too. You're gonna get a chance to do that in the new land that we're creating in Shanghai Disneyland. This will be our first experience based on the inspiring Academy Award-winning film. Here is a first look at how you'll see into Zootopia Central Station and discover animals going about their daily lives. The technology that the Imagineers are using to bring this land to life, it's really, really cutting-edge stuff, as you can see. This is also a brand new piece of concept art that you're seeing for the first time today. You can check out the doors and the apartments of all sizes for animals that might be large or small, and then everything in between. Like you guys, I love all these little details that you see in here. Now, you'll make your way to the Zootopia Police Department, which doubles as the entrance for the land's new family attraction. And there, you're gonna be meted by Officer Klauhauser. Our Shanghai team just released this video clip just a few hours ago, and I wanted you to have a first look at it.
你不知道啊，今晚的演唱会可是夏季阳的演唱会，哦，夏季阳。
And while we are talking about lovable characters, Mickey's favorite teddy bear, Duffy. Oh, we got some Duffy fans in here. He has been a huge fan favorite in our Asia parks for years. But listen, things went to a whole new level in Shanghai when we introduced his newest friend, Lena Bell. All right, a few Lena Bell fans in here. Well, just this week, that inquisitive fox made her debut at Hong Kong Disneyland and Tokyo DisneySea, and the response has been ridiculous. So I thought you might want to meet her too as a special D23 Expo treat. You don't get to see these characters from overseas that much, so why not? Everybody making her first appearance ever in the United States, please welcome the one and only Lena Bell. You are cute, Lena Bell. And as you can see, she's always looking for another mystery to solve. And while she continues to live in our parks in Asia, I am so excited to announce that Duffy and friends, they're gonna star in their own show on Disney Plus. Yeah, it's gonna be really cool. It's a 6-episode stop motion animated series debuting next year. And if you wanna hear more about Duffy and friends, please be sure to check out the panel later at this afternoon's panel at Hyperion Theater. Looks like Lena may have found another clue there. Lena Bell, thank you so much for joining us. It was great to see you. You're so cute. I know you don't get a chance to see that much, and I saw you guys buying a lot of merchandise out there from Lena Bell, so I figured, what the heck. Now, when you all leave today, we have a Lena Bell pin for all of you. It is only available in our Asia park, so this one is really, really special. We brought it to D23 Expo as a gift in honor of Lena Bell's visit, so enjoy that. You know, whether we are talking about Duffy and Friends or Zootopia or any of our other parks experience, the Disney difference, it comes from our incredible storytelling. And that all stems from who our original storyteller. And that's why, as part of Disney's 100th anniversary, I am so happy to announce that next year, Hong Kong Disneyland will unveil a brand new statue of Walt and Mickey. This is a tribute to that famous moment when Walt watched his children on the merry-go-round, that one little spark that eventually led him to create the thing we all love, Disneyland. Now here, he sits on a bench, but this time behind the Castle of Magical Dreams in Hong Kong. And we'll have a commemorative print of this wonderful statue for you on your way out today. Anything Walt and Mickey, I love. We are so proud of this. Now, Hong Kong Disneyland is home to one of three new Frozen-themed lands that we're developing around the world. You can see the land in Hong Kong in this new rendering that we're debuting for you today. World of Frozen in Hong Kong is going to feature two attractions, including our first Frozen-themed coaster, Wandering Oaken's Sliding Sleighs. This land, it's really starting to take shape, as you can see here in this brand new footage that we're sharing for the first time. The way Arendelle blends in with the park's natural surroundings on Lantau Island, I think, is just magnificent. And I'm happy to share that World of Frozen will open at Hong Kong Disneyland in the second half of 2023. In Paris, our Frozen-themed land is a huge expansion at Walt Disney Studios Park. You're gonna be immersed in the same magical wintry setting from the films, including a Norway-inspired village and snow-capped mountains. And to connect Arendelle to the rest of the Walt Disney Studios, we're creating an entirely new promenade in the center of this park. Now here's a fresh look that I'm sharing with you all first today, showing how this area will expand the current park and lead you into a new lakeside district. Now, as you make your way back towards Arendelle, you'll pass many beautiful new gardens, and I'm happy to officially announce today that one of these gardens will feature a new Tangle-themed attraction that we're developing for the whole family to enjoy, even the little ones. Now, Frozen is also one of the stories playing a role in the royal transformation of the iconic 5-star Disneyland Hotel in Paris. Every guest room and all the communal areas, they're being rethemed, and they'll take inspiration from classics like Cinderella and Sleeping Beauty, Tangled, and even more. Here's a first look at concept art for one of our Frozen-themed suites. I can't wait for all of you to get a chance to experience this hotel again for yourself when the reimagining is fully complete in 2024. Our third Frozen project is coming to life at Tokyo Disney Resort. But before I get to that, I want to take a moment to recognize a very, very special guest in the audience with us this morning. Would you all please give a warm D23 Expo welcome to Disney legend Toshio Kagami, representative director, chairman, and CEO of Oriental Land Company. We are so, so grateful for our ongoing partnership and everything Kagami-san has contributed to the Tokyo Disney Resort. And just the latest example, Tokyo Disney Sea is creating its 8th port of call right now. It's called Fantasy Springs. This will include 3 distinct stories. Peter Pan will have Tangled and Frozen, plus a gorgeous, gorgeous hotel integrated right into the park. The Frozen attraction will feature several new audio animatronic figures, and I happen to have a preview for all of you today that we haven't shared with anyone yet. Let's take a look. So, as you all heard, Elsa will sing in Japanese, and then her movements will sync specifically to match the rhythm of that language. It's going to be a Frozen experience that you just will not find anywhere else in the world. Since we have 3 Frozen lands in development right now in 3 different markets, we thought it would be great to share maybe a moment representing that story. So please enjoy this beautiful new rendition of Into the Unknown that we've created especially for all of you, and is performed in Cantonese, Japanese, and French. Enjoy it, everyone. That was spectacular. Kevin Feige, if you're out there, don't even try it. Don't even try it. Now, before we leave Tokyo Disney Resort, there's one more project that I want to touch on. Beginning in 2024, Space Mountain at Tokyo Disneyland will undergo a transformation that will bring a new story and experience to this iconic attraction. Here is a first look at how the area will transition from day to night. Beautiful, I think. With a nod to the original architecture, this reimagined Space Mountain will anchor a new plaza that will be complete by 2027, and I think it's just beautiful. This new vision for Tokyo's Tomorrowland and everything that we've talked about today for that matter, it's all about continually pushing ourselves for more and more innovative storytelling, which of course is why I love visiting with our Imagineers, the ones who bring all of these ideas to life for us. Dreaming up new possibilities only Disney would dare to try is what these folks are doing every single day. And again, in this really cool job that I have, I regularly get to watch over their shoulders as they do it. Now, occasionally, they even let me test stuff out. That's usually if they think I can't screw it up, which I usually do, but sometimes they let me test stuff out. Now, Imagineers turn technology on its head to see what else they can do. And this nonstop pursuit of innovation means that they're constantly trying things that have never done before. And you can't be afraid to fail once in a while. As you can see, some of these ideas, they became experiences in our parks, in our resorts, or maybe on our ships, while others teach us lessons that will send our teams down completely new paths. We don't know yet where some of these concepts may take us, and I guess that's kind of the fun part here. Because there are absolutely no boundaries when you're dreaming of a big future like this. You know, we've been like a train just barreling down the tracks for more than six decades since we opened Disneyland Park. And then COVID, it brought that train to a stop. But it also allowed us to spend some time tinkering around a little bit. It was a rare opportunity to stop and think about where we wanted to go. So we took some time to do some things that we've always wanted to try in our parks, but we also had to put a few projects on hold while the world was stopped. Well, now we are back on track. We are picking up steam as we head toward our future and the reimagining possibilities that are in front of us. Now look, what I'm about to share with you is probably going to make a bunch of Disney folks out there nervous. But I think it's going to make you all really excited. Because what we're going to talk about next is way early in the creative process. It's what our Imagineers call blue sky. I want to be clear with everybody in here, though. We are not up here daydreaming. It's important to me that you know these things we're going to talk about, they are very real. They are very serious discussions that I'm having with our teams about the future of our parks and experiences. And I want to touch on a couple of them today because, well, you are our biggest fans, and I want you to see behind that curtain a little bit. Does this sound like it's fun? Okay, I'm sure I'm going to get myself in trouble here. Now, some of you might know, at one point in my career, I was lucky enough to be leading Disney's Animal Kingdom at Walt Disney World. And during that time, I was involved with some of the planning for Pandora, the world of Avatar. It was such an awesome project to be part of, and it was so transformative for Animal Kingdom, and our guests love that land. But you know, I was kind of always thinking about the possibilities for transformation in this other area of the park, and that's Dinoland. I gotta tell you, we see tremendous opportunity here, a chance to tell some new stories that fit right in with what Animal Kingdom is all about. And I am just so excited about it. I can't keep it to myself, so I'm gonna share it with you. And then I figured it would be cool to invite out two key collaborators to come on out here and talk with me about some of our initial ideas. Sound fun? Okay. Well, please welcome Imagineering Creative Portfolio Executive Chris Beatty and the Chief Creative Officer of the Walt Disney Animation Studios and Academy Award-winning filmmaker, Jennifer Lee. Am I making you guys nervous?
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit? Just a little bit nervous?
This is my favorite.
Well, first of all, thank you both for being here today. Before we get to Dinoland, Jen, talk to us about the relationship between animation and Imagineering. What's it like for you to do these incredible things, write and direct a tremendous film like Frozen that becomes an instant classic for everyone, and then see those characters come to life in our parks? What's that like?
I mean, it's a complete rush. I mean, parks, I mean, I don't know you all, they've always meant so much to me. And now to see these stories and characters that we get to work on and that we've created become new experience for the guests, I'm pretty overwhelmed. Give me a minute. I mean, I was listening to Into the Unknown and I was practically turning into pixie dust when you were showing us all the frozen land. So I'll land on Earth in a minute. But you know, speaking for everyone at Disney Animation, to say we love, love, love being a part of the creative process for our parks. Working with Imagineers, I mean,
cool,
we are
pretty cool people, right?
We are your biggest fans. I mean, we are. I have to tell you. So, but what's amazing is how it really is this natural fit. It is like being in our story rooms. It's like bouncing ideas around, crazy ideas sometimes, and then of course they make it happen, and just seeing where the stories take us. And I've been. Chris and I, along with the teams, I'm like all about like what it's like being in there for me, but along with all the Imagineers and the studio filmmakers themselves have been working together and looking at how we can bring the films for this last decade into the parks in natural ways.
All right, so can I continue the love fest?
Yeah, you can get in there. Call you, Chris, go ahead.
It is so true. We love, love partnering with your team at Animation. Getting early insight into the characters and the stories that you're developing, it's critical for us at Imagineering as we move through that blue sky process. Let's go back to Dinoland for a minute. I think that's a great example of where we opened our conversation really, I think, with an important reminder about the ethos of Animal Kingdom. It has to start there.
Yep.
You know, since its beginning, Animal Kingdom has really focused on stories that have this connection to animals and intrinsic values of nature, and most of all, probably the power of transformative adventures. And Josh, a few minutes ago, you talked about Avatar.
Yeah, I love that place.
That is the perfect example of where a narrative and how it embodies these core values to create an experience that could only live at Animal Kingdom.
Yeah, I mean, I completely agree with that, Chris. But Jen, talk to us a little bit about how these values play into our decision-making, if we want to tell more stories in the park. What do we think could happen in Dinoland?
Well, I mean, first of all, understanding the foundation is critical to our creative thinking. And for us, what immediately came to mind when thinking about Animal Kingdom was Zootopia. I mean, how can we tell new stories together about these incredible animals to engage people of all ages?
Exactly. I mean, I remember the first time I sat down and watched Zootopia, watching Judy Hopps board the train and go through those amazing landscapes, and the animals in those environments just jumped off the screen to me as a possibility that could live in Animal Kingdom.
Oh, yeah, I mean, how cool would it be to take our guests into the various districts? I mean, be immersed in Tundra Town, Little Rodentia, Bunny Burrow, the Rainforest District, perhaps even points you haven't seen yet?
I'm sure there are districts and characters we haven't seen yet, right?
Well, not yet. Wink, wink, wink.
I'm waiting too. I'm waiting for that meeting to take place where maybe I get to look behind the curtain a little bit. But in all honesty, look, we love Zootopia, but we can't help as Imagineers but ask ourselves, where else could we go? And your team has done such an amazing job of developing stories that really speak to this idea of connections to nature.
Yeah, when we talked and I thought about this idea of connection, something else that came to mind was Moana, maybe?
Yes, please. I love the idea of Moana being in Animal Kingdom. I mean, her story is one of adventuring beyond the reef, connecting with nature, I mean, in order to heal a broken world and save her people. And I can just imagine getting to journey with her, trying to fight off the Kakamora, meeting mysterious animals and creatures of the deep. It would be thrilling.
Yes, that would be extremely thrilling, and that's exactly how Animal Kingdom, or how Moana can fit into Animal Kingdom. These are the types of stories and narratives that really, I think, speak right to the heart of the park.
I think all of that sounds great, and we have real, real aspirations for this part of the park. We're all so excited about the possibilities here. Now, Chris, I seem to recall at one of those days at Imagineering, you showed me a piece of concept art for what we're talking about here.
We do a lot of concept art, yeah. But yes, I believe we did share some with you early on.
Yeah, and are you gonna be a wimp or are you gonna, are you gonna share?
So you're calling me out on stage,
yeah,
that's what's
calling.
Happening?
You guys, these are our fans here.
But wait, I just wanna know.
These are our fans.
Okay. I just want to know, first of all, I have a job come Monday morning.
You'll always have
all
a
right,
job.
Great. All right, let's just show it. Let's show
all right.
it.
All right.
Okay, look, we're going to show you this. It's big, it's beautiful, it's over the top. And I'd hesitate even to call this a concept. Look, we develop lots of paintings like this to help our teams envision the possibilities of what could be. This is just one of them.
But I love this one.
It's a good one.
But I love this one.
I know.
Yes.
And I know that there's more beyond just that one park, Animal Kingdom. Since we're already pulled back the curtain a little bit here, why not go maybe a little bit further now, making some people really nervous. How would you like to talk about Magic Kingdom?
Please.
All right, Chris, if I recall, you were the creative director for New Fantasyland. And
yes.
I guess up until, like, right now, that was the largest expansion in Magic Kingdom's history.
Yes. I mean, Magic Kingdom holds a special place in my heart. I think there are so many amazing stories yet to be told, lands yet to be explored. Trust me when I say this. At Imagineering, we're always thinking about what is next. And one of the concepts we're most excited about is this idea of new frontiers. Let me give you an example. So, Josh, do you ever wonder if you could travel to the other side of Big Thunder Mountain, what could be there?
And I'm sure that there are about 7,000 people in the audience
probably
who wondered, what exactly is beyond Big Thunder?
All right, well, that's what we're exploring. All right, so go with me. Everyone go with me. So let's take this journey. Imagine, what if we could pass over those spires of Big Thunder Mountain? And maybe in front of us, there's a valley in front of us with the little town of Santa Cecilia, Mexico. And they're celebrating Dia de los Muertos. And what if we could climb on board the back of Albrie and fly into the land of the dead with our familia, just like the Riveras in Coco? That's what could be out there.
And, of course, I mean, I'm just asking, what if we do want to talk about Bruno?
Bruno.
You heard that, Josh. I'm sure you know that there are many of us at Disney Animation who cannot wait to see more Encanto in the parks.
I know we've got some of them here, too.
I mean, who are we kidding? No one could bring a magical house to life like Disney Imagineering. What if you could walk into the Madrigal's casita, just saying, meet the family? What if Maribel is your guide, introducing you to all the wonder within those walls? Bruno's tower, Antonio's room, all of it. What if you could step up to a door and discover your own magical gift?
What if? Jennifer is not gonna stop. And you know what? She shouldn't. These types of ideas are exactly why I'm so glad that you are both here today talking to our biggest fans about what could be on the horizon here. So let's talk about one more.
I thought we talked that we were not.
No.
All right.
One more.
All right.
Chris, come on.
All right.
Do it.
Yes, let's do it. Let's
share
it.
Well, listen, I know this one is not planned anytime soon, but it's something that we know all of you talk about. And it's a fun idea that's always in the back of our minds, and it's an area overrun by villains.
I'm gonna guess this hasn't just crossed our mind, but 7,000 other people as well would love maybe to see this idea happen.
And I know we love to hate, but mostly love, adore, and sometimes a little too obsessively adore our villains.
It's true.
All right, well, Chris, here I go again. I'm pretty sure that you shared another early concept or thought starter for the Magic Kingdom 2.
Well, I mean,
come on.
You already called me a wimp once, so I guess I'm just going to go ahead and
just go
with it. Going for it now, right? All right, let's roll. Let's show it. So, once again, this is a thought starter, but you can see here the villains looming overhead with Casa Magrial in the distance, and then we arrive at Santa Celia. That's what could be out there beyond Big Thunder Mountain.
In trouble now, but I gotta say, this looks fantastic. Beyond Big Thunder Mountain is gonna be so cool. I can't wait to keep talking more with you both about these ideas and to start locking some of this in. Animation is where all of this began 100 years ago, and we have such a rich collection of stories to draw from. With your teams working closely together, I want to hear more. I want to share more with all of these fans. Jen, Chris, you guys are awesome. Thank you.
Thank you, John.
Thank you, D23 Expo.
I'll say it maybe for the 10th time today. You can see why I love this stuff. I just want to make sure that you know that we are constantly thinking about what's next. Because as Bob said on Friday, Disney is a company of unrivaled creativity, and we are never, never going to stop working towards that next great idea. We're never going to stop surprising you. We're never going to stop delighting you or pushing the boundaries of where we can all go together. We're always, always in search of Walt's great, big, beautiful tomorrows. This is a relationship between us at Disney and you, our greatest fans and our guests. We dare to dream it, and you all complete the picture. I have a new video that I wanted to share with you all that I think sums up this idea perfectly. We haven't shown it to anyone yet because, well, we've been saving it just for you. I think it gets right to the heart of our special relationship with you. Let's take a look.
Hey, PD. I can't sleep.
Why?
Do you want to go to Disney?
Yes.
What if we went to Disney World today?
We really are. Are we literally going to Disney?
The magic's been there from the very beginning.
The smells, the sights, the sounds. There's something in the air that is so special and unique.
Where's Mickey?
The way it connects one-to-one with our guests. Over and over.
Oh my goodness.
Across the country and around the world. Stories become more meaningful.
Which one would you like to choose? The Hulk.
I can't wait to see a princess. I'm so excited.
You look like a really good Buzz Lightyear.
I would fly.
Stories become more personal.
You are now a knight of the kingdom.
With you at the center,
Julie.
Everything comes to life.
Just the fact that we were together, doing all the activities together.
Let's go.
We're all in it, and we're on the moment.
Together, we make the memories that will live in your heart.
I feel like we're celebrated here, and that's so nice to share with other people.
Together, we make the impossible possible.
This is a dream come true for me.
Because the magic of Disney is nothing compared to what happens when we share it with you. Now and forever.
I always wonder what Disney will do next.
Cheers to many more memories.
Yay! Every turn I take, every trail I track,
every path I make, every road leads back
to the place I know where I cannot go,
where I long to be.
See the line of the sky, once you see, it calls me.
Calls me. And no one knows how far it goes.
If the wind and my sail and the sea stays behind me.
One day I'll know how far we'll go.
Goodbye, citizen.
Well, there you go. At Disney Parks, experiences and products, everything that we want to do, you can be found in those magical moments like you just saw. Whether you're hugging a character or you're riding an attraction or you're visiting a far off place or maybe you're playing a game or spending time with your loved ones, whatever it is, we're inviting all of you into our story so that you can make us part of your story. That's, I think, what this is all about. And there's no telling how far we will go all together. Because I believe that the best is to come, which is saying something, considering that we're about to celebrate our 100th anniversary at Disney. I mean, think about this. Since 2016, we've added more than 200 new lands and experiences and attractions and festivals and so much more. And we've done that literally around the world. And that's why when I tell you that we're just getting started, I hope that you know I really, really mean this. This year, we unveiled Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind, the Disney Wish, Star Wars Galactic Star Cruiser, and Avengers Campus in Disneyland Paris. Next year, we've got Mickey's Toontown, we've got Tron, we've got World of Frozen and World Celebration. In 2024, we're bringing you Tiana's Bayou Adventure. Story Living by Disney's gonna be up and running. And then the Disney Treasure, as we talked about today. And that's not even all. There's so much more good stuff coming. So many new experiences. Yeah, and even more that I can't tell you about just yet. We have a massive library of stories and characters to draw from, and we are planning more attractions. We're gonna give you more entertainment. We're gonna give you more special moments and more ways to make your time with us even better. More of what you love about Disney. Right now, as we all sit here today in Hall D23, Imagineers are out there thinking of the next great experience you can't find anywhere else but with us. It's how we've defined ourselves for the first 100 years, and it's going to define our next 100 as well. Which brings me back to where we started this morning. Beginning in January, oh my gosh, do we have a 100th anniversary celebration in store for all of you. As you know, we're calling it Disney 100 Years of Wonder. And as Bob said, it's gonna be the biggest celebration in our company's history. Throughout 2023, we're inviting you to share the wonder with us on social media because we want to hear more of your Disney stories. Each of our destinations around the world, on land and at sea, will showcase the anniversary in their own way. We'll have plenty of new entertainment, we'll have new merchandise, we'll have special new food, we'll have drinks, and so much more. There will be more to share on all of this very soon. But I can tell you that the heart of this entire celebration will be right here in California at the Disneyland Resort. Beginning in late January, the happiest place on earth will receive new platinum-infused decor and new looks for Mickey and Minnie and her pals. We'll have special live entertainment moments that will pop up across the resort, including the long-awaited return of the Magic Happens Parade this spring. And I love that one. I can't wait to experience it with all of you. Trust me, I will be out there. And I'm excited to announce that starting in late January, Disneyland Resort will showcase not one, but two new nighttime spectaculars. At Disney California Adventure, World of Color 1 will celebrate the storytelling legacy all started by Walt. It is going to be a world of color like nothing that you've seen before, with an all-new inspiring story told through some of your favorite characters. And then, the new nighttime spectacular debuting at Disneyland Park, Wondrous Journeys, will ignite the wonder in all of us. It'll feature nods to all 60 Walt Disney Animation Studios films to date, taking us on a journey filled with artistry, filled with music and storytelling, and of course, a ton of heart. It'll continue to build upon Disneyland's state-of-the-art projection effects, turning areas of the park into an artist's canvas that brings characters to life around you as the fireworks dance up in the sky. This show will feature an absolutely incredible new song. You want to hear it, right? All right, you got it. This is the world premiere of It's Wondrous, just for our D23 Expo fans.